So, last we left off, you guys were exploring the city of Ujarak a bit, maybe talking to some succubi that own the local brothel. She explained what she was doing there, talking about how, yes, while she is evil in nature, she's merely providing a service that people require, whatever. And she is more than content to feed off of the negative emotion brought in by the people who visit her brothel. And you guys made the conclusion that she's not really harming anyone. She's just kind of existing. She's got a sweet deal for herself, but she's just doing. She's fine, probably. Maybe. Meanwhile, Demir was kind of chatting up all of the people that happened to be visiting the brothel at the time, and discovered that the ship you guys hired, I believe it was the Eye of the Beholder, was in fact a pirate ship. And so you guys reconvened at the local inn, to discuss whether you would like to continue with this pirate ship, under the possibility that you may be asked to engage in piracy, or if you wanted to try to find another boat and end up losing the money you already paid up front for the pirate. Hawk brought up that another ship that the dock master had suggested was called the Moon Kiss. But that is where we find ourselves now, trying to decide between the Moon Kiss and the Eye of the Beholder.
I
A
believe
little
we
bit of
decided
piracy.
on changing from the Beholder to the Moon Kiss just because, yeah, we'd be losing out on some of the money that we paid, but it would just be a much safer option than potentially being used for piracy.
That's what you guys were leaning towards, but nothing was for sure confirmed.
Well, Tobias is gonna change those fucking minds real fast if he has anything to say about it.
Septimus, by the way, contributes that she's more interested in going with the pirate, because it sounds like more of an adventure.
Well, honey, you know what? We can't always get what we want in life. We're not doing the pirates.
Little piracy never hurt nobody.
Well, honey, we don't always get what we want in life. We're not doing
We
the
had a
pirates.
big storm coming.
Honey, you got a big storm coming.
Hacha.
No, seriously, if you stand out there, you're gonna get soaked to the fucking bone.
Samir is also kind of on the like, I don't know, pirates could be fun side, but
Tobias will
she's
bring
not
up.
arguing. She's not arguing with Septim or on Septimus's side. It's more like Septimus says like, "Oh, pirates would be fun," and Demir's like, "Yeah, pirates would be fun," says nothing.
Tobias will bring up the fact that we will be in a whole new world of troubles if we are used for piracy. And the authorities find out about it.
But what about all of our money, Tobias? We did pay them an awful lot of money already.
Tobias just kind of like gives Lish a deadpan stare and says, I've seen you spend more on less. Like, it's just money. We can go kill some bandits or some other fucking shit.
Yeah, but what would the cost on our souls be if we engage in piracy? I'd say that's less.
In the morning?
No, it's still the evening.
It's still the evening.
But yeah, so. So I say losing the amount of money we've deposited in the ship is better for. I agree with Toby.
I don't particularly want to thieve and pillage, so as long as we're in agreement.
I'm not keen on it either, and I even more so would not want to be strong-armed into killing over a deal we probably didn't consider everything about.
I have no objections. I think Toby is very straightforward and wise. Probably.
Probably.
Pirates would be a detour at this point.
And who's to say they'll even let us, if we even assist them with piracy, who's to say they'll even let us actually have anything that's plundered?
Oh, they wouldn't. That was part of the deal. We didn't get a cut of anything.
Exactly. There's no fucking point.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would be more worried about them trying to profit off of us than pirate with us, I suppose. But
yeah, weren't they... Wasn't one of the rumors that they took captives? What if we ended up captives?
They'd have another thing coming.
Fair. And I would bet on us or pirate.
Someone get this girl some water.
You really gotta stop drinking so much.
Also, probably. Nothing was said about the pirates taking anyone captive.
Where the hell did I get that from, then?
Somebody was concerned that we would be held hostage, but I don't know how much of an actual risk that would be. I don't know.
It was more so the understanding of we'd be going onto a really large ship, and there would be we would be heavily outnumbered, and so... Mm. If we do end up having, like, if they do end up coming across a merchant ship and looting it, they may force us to help them, and we won't be able to stop that because we would just be outnumbered. Tobias's solution to that would be to sink their boat.
There's also, though, just to throw it out there, no guarantee that the other ship isn't also pirates. I have a feeling that most ships here engage in some form of shady behavior because it is kind of the shady behavior port.
There are other shady behavior. If we are going to be on, you know, some sort of good ship, either way, which I would much rather not, but if it has to happen either way, it may as well be the one we've already paid. We could also spend some more time looking into, you know, our other options and how reputable they may or may not be.
There are illegal sea trades other than piracy, though.
Yeah, like we could get on with like some good smugglers or something.
Smugglers, black markets, maybe both.
Yeah. And just, you know, blind eye to that, I suppose.
Yeah, not necessarily something I'd condone, but it's better than piracy.
shades of gray and all that.
Mm. Really, whether or not we'd be forced to do anything. But we can't really figure out what's the moon kiss? Is that what it's called?
The moon kiss, yes.
Okay, yeah. Now we can't really find out what the moon kiss does at this hour, unfortunately, so all that's left to do is really sleep off until the morning.
So, since it's been a couple weeks, just as a reminder, you paid the Eye of the Beholder to depart from here at dawn.
It's kind of a tight turnaround, so either we decide tonight what we're doing, or we might be getting on that ship tomorrow morning, so.
Hawk, make a general intelligence check.
Need to find if I remember if I have a general intelligence modifier. Just make the check. I just need to know what I need to add to it, if anything. Okay, 4, 7.
Okay. I mean, it didn't really seem like the other ship might have been a pirate ship, but you don't know.
From a distance,
we are on a pirate island, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
They could all be pirates.
Or, again, it could be...
Less that it's a pirate island, and more that this is the best place to stop when traveling north or south. And people might be paid off to look the other way by some ships, and people may not otherwise.
Perhaps we should ask, like, the innkeeper, or perhaps some people that are still up around the inn, inquire about the moon kiss a little bit more thoroughly.
Mm-hmm. Sounds like a good idea.
All right, then let's go do that.
All right. So who is going to be asking around in the Rowdy Raven?
I can.
All right. Why don't you each roll a general investigation check, or you can, one of you can have advantage.
Can I, how's your investigation, Avery?
+12.
Your investigation? Jesus Christ, what's the advantage?
She found another expertise point.
God.
The benefits of being a bard, baby. Oh, wow. I really needed that advantage. That is a 16. I rolled a 4 and a 1.
All right.
This dice is going away now.
So you ask around about the moon kiss. You hear that it's a caravel ship that tends to stop here in Ujarak relatively frequently. No sign of any suspicious activity you hear. It's more like they bring supplies to Alburn from Howie and it back. Less of a merchant ship, more of just cargo transfer. You also hear that the captain is bit more of a reclusive fellow. Doesn't tend to come to the rowdy raven himself, preferring to keep to himself a bit. But he is a Githyanki. But you don't really hear anything about him that raises any red flags.
Okay, Demir will report that to the group. What is a Githyanki? I've never heard of that.
I don't think that Hawk has any reason he would know, but the temptation to roll for it is strong.
Can I roll for it?
Yeah, folks who would like to can roll an Arcana check.
Yeah, Tobias will roll.
Yeah. 7.
25.
Hell yeah.
All right. Tobias, you have read about Githyanki before. You know that there are two Gith races, Githyanki and Githzerai. But the Githyanki live generally on the astral plane, and they are descendants of a race that was enslaved by Mind Flayer. And sometimes they are known for piracy within the astral plane, but you get the impression just based off of what everything that Demir and Lish are saying about what they've heard about this guy, maybe there's a reason he decided to leave the astral plane. But they're generally like tall and slender with kind of yellowy leather-like skin and like black eyes. They're strange people.
Tobias will relay this information to the party and add the fact that he's a Githyanki could explain why he might be a bit of a recluse as well. I imagine people will have the wrong opinions.
But there's certainly no reason why we couldn't go and chat with him in the morning if he's by his ship. We may have put a deposit down on the pirate ship, but there's not really a rush. We can talk, and if this moon kiss is not good enough, then there are other ships in the harbor.
Yes. And I feel that we may have a better chance of, or at least there's less of a concern of piracy occurring with the Moonkiss due to the fact that it's a cargo ship.
If anything, it might be subject to piracy.
We can offer us protection.
That, I feel, would be a better position for us to be in.
Mm-hmm. Agreed.
All right. So it sounds like you guys are skipping out on the pirate and going to make a plan to talk to the captain of the Moonkiss tomorrow morning. All right. No one's correcting me, so I'm assuming I got that right.
Sounds right.
All right. So you guys head to your rooms for the evening. I assume you all take your long rest. And is anyone doing any weird shenanigans before bed?
Uh,
I am doing weird shenanigans. I have three sendings to send. First, to Itri.
All right.
Evening, Itri. Delay on ship to mainland. Might have chartered a pirate ship accidentally, changing vessel, might cost money. Gods be with ye.
I appreciate the update. Stay safe. Watch out for oceanic creatures. The children seem worried about something.
Fuck. Well, at least mom's there. Okay, sending number two. Dad. Isn't there like a 5% when going to a different plane that it doesn't go through?
Like, are you thinking like actual dad or stepdad?
Actual dad, in this case. Okay. Yeah, 5% chance. So... don't roll a one. Okay. Hi, Dad. Traveling for work. And came across asshole priest. Didn't want to cause a interfaith incident. Is there anything you can do? Love you.
Your dad does not necessarily communicate in words. And so the impression that you get in response to the sending is the priest you encountered just being small and petty and not even worth time or focus.
She tried. Third sending. Madam, what?
Who are you looking for?
Character. No, not character. Encountered NPCs. Here we go. Lady Lena. Okay. Lilna. Madam Lilna.
Mm-hmm.
Madam Lilna. Pardon my intrusion. I am jealous of your integration into society as an outsider. Do you have any tips? I don't know how to sign off with a, and she runs out of words.
Okay. Lady Lilna gets back to you. It is easy to integrate, as you say, when you are an object of desire among folk, or common folk.
Well, that's not helpful.
Her voice just kind of licks at your mind, and you know, there's a strange desire for touch, but not much else.
Okay.
No actual enchantment, even though her voice is enchanting.
Just a base sensuality to it. But yeah, well, that was helpful. I guess Valk knocks on the other room's door.
Alright.
Sticks her head in, I guess, since no one's answering.
Position are you guys in?
Well, I was going to say, you didn't really give people a chance to respond. Tobias will answer the door.
Hi, Tobias. I contacted Itri, and apparently the kids are worried about something. And I've share with party.
Shit. Will you be able to send a message tomorrow?
Let's see. I can't deny it. I have more spells.
Would you be able to ask him specifics on what is causing them concern? Because while I find comfort knowing that Levy is there, with the forces that we're potentially dealing with, it's better to have an idea of what... It's better to know if the concern is something we need to be concerned about, or if it's like, I got a bad grade in school kind of concern, you know?
No, but I think I get what you're saying.
Think of it like this. Nim is the name, out of character, Nim is the name of Valk's stepbrother, correct? Okay. I just wanted to make sure that I say the correct name and not like say a different character name and then be like, yeah, the stepbrother, and everyone's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Tobias says, think of it like this. There are two different levels of concern. One being, say you want to get Nim a nice gift for his birthday, but you don't know what exactly to get him. You're worried about it, but it's not gonna be like life ending. And then there's the other type of concern of, did the vampire come back to our house? Kind of concern that could potentially result in death. Or another case, the Raksha showing up again. That's the kind of concerns I'm talking about.
No, I got that. My school experiences are a little different.
Tobias puts his hand on Valk's shoulder and says, if it makes you feel any better, I never went to school.
My name's Tobias. I'm 17 and I never learned how to read.
My name's Tobias. I'm 25 and never learned how to read.
I will say that there are potentially several people at the house that you could message. There's Levey. There's Itri. There's the children themselves. There's Itri's three guards. And then there's Nymph.
Tobias and will Demir suggest that...
over here... Oh, sorry.
Oh, yeah. Demir would be able to overhear because it's they're having just more of like a casual conversation kind of thing.
I assume you guys were kind of standing in the doorway.
Yeah, we were standing in the doorway, so it's not like it's hidden. Tobias
and I rolled a perception 13. I don't know if that makes a difference.
Yeah, I mean that's fine.
Valk's not exactly being subtle right now.
Yeah. Tobias will suggest that Valk either reaches out to Levey or he can Valk can reach out to Itri if she wants, but Levey might be the better choice because the kids are a lot closer with her, and so they will probably tell her about, or at least like the details of concerns that they have.
Yes.
I could use my scrying orb. It might be easier to have a full conversation.
That, if you're able to, that might be the better choice, just so we don't have to deal with the word limit, and also you can actually see kind of what is happening. Thank you, Valk, for letting us know about this right away.
Yes, of course. Do crystal ball, let me know if you still need me. At which point, Valk kind of steps away from the door, bounces off of hallway side, and back into her room.
Tobias will call after her, make sure to drink some water, please.
Right.
Why is Valkyria messaging my brother?
Well, from what she said, she was just updating him on the progress of our stuff. So I'm assuming just to let him know.
Why does she need to update him on anything?
I don't know. So that he knows we didn't fucking die somewhere? I was literally just about to message my own dad to let him know that I'm not fucking dead out in the woods somewhere. I get the concern you don't want Itri involved. However, I don't personally see anything wrong if it's we're just sending him a message to let him know, hey, we're still alive. We're still in progress of getting your guys' mom back. How would you feel if Itri went off somewhere and then was just gone for days and you know that he was going to a witch's hut with just no, with no word on what's happening? Wouldn't you be worried?
But why is it Valkyria's job to be messaging Itri over Demir?
Valkyria just decided to do it because she has the means to do it. We both know Demir's not going to.
Demir has the means to.
But she's not going to.
Obi, are you okay? You seem angry at me.
Shit, sorry, I think I'm playing Tobias a little too aggressively today. My bad. My bad, Obi. My bad.
I mean, you got upset earlier today.
That... That's more so... I'm not upset at you for that. It's something internal that I'm trying to piece together myself. And I need a little more time to figure out why.
Why you're upset at me?
Why I feel the way that I do about something.
I'll certainly take as much time as you need, but in the meantime, I'm not appreciating it.
I'm sorry, Demir.
I'm sorry if I upset you. But either way, it's... Valkyria is getting intrusive, and it is bothering me. I can message my brother anytime I want. And in fact, I can. I'll do it. Right now, if you want. But I think it might be better to talk to Levey. Like you said earlier, she's the one more connected with the children. So which do you think I should do?
Tobias will bow his head and say, do what you feel is right.
Are you just giving up? Because I'm not being aggressive, I am asking your opinion. I value it.
I do not want to make it seem that I'm forcing you into choosing an option or trying to push you into picking something. I don't want to make it seem like that I have power over you in that way.
It's not power over me if I am asking for it. Give me your opinion, your true opinion, Tobias.
I think that Levey would be best.
I agree. Do you want me to say anything to her for you?
you can tell her that we miss her and hope that she is well.
Demir is going to look over at Lish and just, do you have anything?
Send her kisses.
Okay. Demir will take out her scrying orb and sit down and focus on Levy and try and scry.
All right. So you focus in on the scrying orb, and your vision clarifies, and you can see Levy out in the graveyard, actually. She is working on trying to cultivate and, like, plant things and maybe tidy up some of the headstones that are out there for the Tri-C family. But yeah, it's getting to be evening, but she is still out there. You can tell that she's kind of doing that thing where, like, I gotta do this now or I'm gonna forget about it.
Levy, hello.
She looks up. Oh my gosh, it is so good to hear from you.
Yes, well, first of all, we miss you very, very much. Tobias sends his love, and so does Lish. Oh my gosh,
I miss all of you so much, too. Are y'all being safe, wherever you are?
Well, we're in a pirate town.
Oh.
But so far, no pirates that we have fought or anything like that, although we did.
That's good, at least. Want to stay away from that. That's not a good idea, generally. I think.
I don't know. It seems somewhat entertaining. But,
I mean, as long as y'all are being smart about it.
That's the key, isn't it? We heard from Itri that the children are upset about something.
Really?
Yes. Have you not?
I mean, they've been taking space the last day or so, but I figure that's just because they're about to be teenagers.
Well, I mean, I don't know anything. I don't know what's going on there, but I can only report what Valkyria told me that Itri told her.
Well, I can try and talk to them about it, but I don't know if they'll want to talk, but I can certainly try. At the very least, I'll keep an eye on them, make sure they're not getting into any trouble.
Okay. Take care of yourself, Levy.
You know, that's what I'm trying to do. And make sure you're doing the same as well. I love all of you. And I want to make sure that you guys are being safe. Don't go dying on me, any of you.
Of course not. And I can check in again with you later, if that would...
That would be wonderful. In the meantime, you can tell everyone that I love them very much. Give them kisses for me. And I'm doing a little bit of wedding planning for Tobias and I, seeing if I can figure out a good space for it, doing some research, you know, in addition to all the other research. It's been real nice having this time off, but I do miss y'all.
I'm so glad. Just keep an eye out on all of them.
Of course. And no sign of that vampire or anything. Best I could tell, maybe still, I don't know, hiding out somewhere. I don't know.
I mean,
he hasn't shown up, so.
Well, given that he might be trying to avoid what we are dealing with in the prime material plane, I don't know how eager he will be to take shelter where everything is falling apart. But
I mean, fuck, I don't think it's just the material plane that's getting fucked up. Been talking to Itri and to Aldrich, and it seems like it's just all getting weird.
I guess we'll find out when we go to the Shadowfell.
No. Well, you'll be careful there. I've heard that it's pretty fucking sketchy.
Well, the little bit we saw was...
I can do some research if you want on the Shadowfell. I honestly don't know too much about it, but again, got access to the library and stuff and the college, but I can look up some information if that would be helpful.
Yes, if you could. We're looking for an undying phoenix. Undead phoenix.
Okay, because I was going to say undying and undead are two different things. Especially for phoenixes. Like, yeah, I mean, I'll look it up. I'll see what I can do. Something like that, bound to have books somewhere.
Yes, I mean, we found a little bit about it, and Demir will explain what they've learned, like researching both the phoenix, the dragon, and the witch queen, and kind of info dump to Levy about it, and just like, if you find anything, if you see anything, I will be sure to check in before we hot planes. I can't reach out once we're in a different plane, but
you can see that makes her look very worried.
But I believe Valkyria will still be able to reach out in an emergency. And Levy, if I don't know what that woman has planned with my little brother, but if you could just keep an eye on that from your side.
I mean, I look out in what way? I don't think Valk is gonna like try and smite him or anything.
No, I'm less worried about her fighting him and more worried about her trying to be too friendly.
I would not worry about that. He already told me he's got a boyfriend.
What?
Just mention it in passing.
A boyfriend?
I don't know any details. Just mention it.
Who?
I said I don't know.
A boyfriend?
I was asking him about what sort of things he's been up to in my hobbub, trying to get this shit just as vaguely all figured out, and mentioned that he had been hanging out with a boy, got a boyfriend, and I didn't want to press because I don't know him that well.
Okay. yeah, I mean, if you find out anything else.
Well, I mean, I'll try to be careful about it. And I'll let you know if I can.
Okay. Thank you, Levey. And,
All right. Love you so much.
I love you
too. Love all of you.
We all love you, and we sorely miss you.
Miss you as well. So much.
Don't forget the kisses.
Oh, Lish sends kisses. And I do as well.
Give everyone kisses for me.
Of course. And I will close out the scry. And turn to Lish and Toby and give them both kisses from Levey.
Hooray!
My brother is gay.
Snort.
Neat.
I mean, Tobias, I
fucking love you.
This is why I'm sitting here feeling like shit because he upset his wife and then just going, thumbs up, me.
This is like the verbal and thematic opposite of the that's rough buddy scene.
Luke is like, and how did you find that out?
Levey said that he mentioned a boyfriend. A boyfriend? Yes. Friend.
He didn't tell you.
Not like you've been avoiding him or anything, dummier.
Well, at least he's been on his own, so my parents couldn't freak out about it.
Would they freak out about it?
I don't know. I suppose because it is Itri, he could do nothing wrong, but my parents were very clear about their expectations of me. I figured they would be the same with him.
Well, you have said that they've treated you both relatively differently.
Very differently. So, I'm sure they would be over the moon. Well, that's something to think about for later.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, Levey, sorry, I got sidetracked. Levey said that she didn't notice anything from the kids, that they were just distant, but she thought that that was more to do with them being teenagers. So I can call her back tomorrow or in a few days' time and see what she has learned on that topic.
That's at least a comfort, knowing that on that front, it's not a world-ending concern, for once. Like, a more normal concern.
We hope. Who knows? There's probably a difference between what they are telling Levey and what they are telling others.
I hope that it doesn't turn out to be something related to out of character. What's the name of the crime
king of cut purses?
The king of cut purses. That's what it was. I was trying to remember it off the top of my head. Back in character. I hope that it's ultimately not something from the King of Cut versus rearing its head again.
I hope not. That would be very inconvenient at this moment. Well, you know, of all the places, though, we might be able to find out more about this King of Cut Purses here. If we are here for another day, perhaps we could try asking around.
That's actually a good point. Given kind of what this town is a hub for, it might even be one of the safer places to inquire about it. It's could still be a risky endeavor, but I don't know when exactly we'd come across another chance like this.
Well, we are probably going to be here for at least a few more hours while we arrange with the new ship. We can use that time wisely.
And if it looks like it might be too risky to inquire or put a target on our backs or whatever, we can always stop. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't think asking around and being curious is going to put a target on us, but...
True.
We mean them no trouble. All we want is to check in on our wards, that is all, and make sure that they are not choosing unwisely for themselves. I am sure that a man with that much of an organization under him would be understanding of that concern. We have no nefarious purposes with his organization, so we have nothing to worry about. I think.
Well.
We can certainly look into it in the morning.
I think that would be for the best.
Demir kind of looks at her scrying ball for a few more seconds and just,
is there anyone else that we needed to spy on? I don't need to. I can't speak to anyone else, but I can at least look. I have 2 more charges before dawn.
T Tobias will ask Demir if she's willing to scry on Ofsi just to see if he's doing well.
Of course. Happy to. I will get my scrying orb out. I already have it out, so I will give him a scry.
All right. Let's see. He's in the same time zone as Levy. So it's evening. he is... What will he be doing at this point in the day? Vision clarifies, and you see he is carving some more arrowheads right now. And he is sitting near, you can see the archdruidess, the older woman, who seems to be meditating. And neither of them are really talking. They're just sitting there, both each in their kind of quiet contemplation.
Can I see, are they in the Adai forest, or is
they
it?
They are in the Adai forest.
Do I recognize where they are, or is it just like they are in the forest?
Roll a perception check.
Okay. Ooh, that is a, hold on. That is a 22, Dark
Team. 22. You don't recognize the space specifically, but it does seem to be some sort of clearing among the old growth. You can see the trees just beyond them. There are a few mushrooms growing here and there, and ferns as well. They're both sitting on the dirt ground. There are some patches of burned wood nearby that you can see. And you very much get the impression that the archdruidess came out here to meditate, and Ofsi went with her so that he could act as a guard.
Yeah, I will just very carefully observe for the whole scry. And then when I come out, tell Tobias everything that she saw and was seeing. But he's with the archdruidess, so he must have made his way back to the woods. Seems that they are further south. There wasn't as much ice or snow. So, seems like he is well and hearty.
Tobias has a fond expression on his face as he says, "I'm glad to hear that. Thank you, Demir."
Of course, I'm sure he would love to hear from you tonight. And Demir is just going to tuck, like lift up Lish's arm and tuck herself under it.
Let her and kind of pull her close. Kind of does the same with Toby, where he just like kind of holds his arm out, his other arm, for Toby to snuggle in if he wants.
Uh, Tobias will, after he steps away briefly off to the side and uses his sending stone, mm-hmm. and sends a message to Ofsi that says, I miss you, Dad. I love you. Currently in... And then he says the name of the town. I'm just having a hard time remembering it.
Ujarak.
Which one?
Ujarak.
Ujarak. And that'll be his message to Ofsi, I mean.
Ofsi will speak up and say, Tobias, good to hear from you. Miss you too. Make sure you visit soon. Be careful. I hear Ujarak is kind of sketchy. Love you lots. All right. Does anyone else have any weird things they want to do this evening before bed?
Nope.
All right. So sleep comes to you all eventually. Nothing noteworthy happens overnight, but you all come to consciousness again in the Rowdy Raven, and true to its name, the inn itself is, it seems to be full of partiers at all hours of the day, which, you know, ships come in at different times of day, people want to get off the boat and get drunk and all that fun stuff. So, you know, it's a bustling, busy place, and I assume that you do not go to get at the pirate ship as agreed upon at dawn. Do you think you stay in town?
Should we send a messenger to the pirate ship so that they don't come looking for us?
You didn't get the impression that the captain is really the type to go looking for you guys. The agreement was that you pay, they leave at dawn, with or without you.
Oh, okay. Cool. As long as... I just don't want us to end up with a bunch of angry pirates trying to figure out why we weren't there.
Yeah, I already have your money.
Mm-hmm. Fair enough.
In the morning, Aaron's going to try to wake up as early as he can. Hopefully before anyone else is awake.
Mm-hmm. All right. What do you do at this early morning hour?
He is going to send a message over into the next room where he knows Lish is. And say, what do you think is the likelihood that we are being watched or listened to here? Be it from any of the magic folk interested in us, or the common worries of being in a pirate town?
And you're saying this to Lish?
To Lish, yes.
Lish just kind of hums, says, I don't think there's a non-zero option as far as eavesdroppers, but we are likely as alone as we're going to be. Are you concerned?
Aaron messages him back. I've needed to talk to you for a bit, but I've been worried that we were being listened to. I mean, especially at the Hags. Care to join me for a walk?
Lish's eyebrows kind of go up. And he's just kind of nods and says, yes, that's fine.
Aaron will leave his room. And just wait out in the hallway.
Is this in the morning, correct?
This is in the very early morning. This is in the no one else is up. Aaron's just assuming that Lish has probably finished trancing by now.
Mm-hmm, probably. Okay. Wee hours of the morning walk. Lish kind of looks Aaron over to kind of judge how he's dressed, if he's dressed warmly enough for a very early morning walk.
It's pretty chilly here.
He's got
the air. Does Aaron have pajamas? Be able to see your breath pretty easily. Maybe a little flush on the side of the road.
Aaron does have pajamas, I've decided. Whatever. He's wearing yes. And you know, he's got one of his coats thrown on. Mm-hmm. He looks like he just got up, but like he is expecting it to be colder.
Mm-hmm. Can slowly close the door softly behind him and get go downstairs.
All right, yeah, Aaron heads out the bar and just into the streets. So, Lish.
DM, real quick, was there like a park or some kind of more outdoorsy area that was not too far from the inn, or was it mostly just kind of like houses?
Mostly houses, lots of various shops and storage areas. There is a bathhouse up the road a little way. But not, this isn't really the a national park sort of area.
Sure, no, that's
shocker.
Fine.
That
he kind of steers us. I kind of steer us more towards like any not too far away, like little shopping district, maybe just. Keep us away from the seedier areas as we walk around.
Yeah, and Aaron's following whatever lead Lish sets.
He just kind of looks at you and appears to be waiting.
Yeah, Aaron looks worried. And you notice he's not really meeting your eye as we walk, but he does start talking. He says, so I guess I've had a question I've been kicking around, not really a plan, but something I want to check with you if could be a plan.
Oh.
We've obviously a lot of our compatriots have made various deals with big old great powers. And I reserve my judgment on how they have gone about it. I myself have made it a deal, as you well know. And I guess I wanted to ask if there is a way to, I don't know, like, do so responsibly, like, figure out what you're willing to put on the table, and what exact terms you want back, and, you know, be careful enough in how you're writing it that it goes off in the expected manner.
Are you asking for just general advice on how to make agreements? Or specifically, are you angling for some sort of agreement with me?
No, general advice. You can actually see Aaron's face goes a little bit red when you ask if he wanted to make a deal with you specifically. Just in general, what your thoughts are on the viability of such a thing.
Well, it certainly is possible. It really depends on which creature you're trying to make a deal with. Are you planning on making a deal with anyone?
I want to see if it is an option available to me.
For what, Aaron?
We've got some really big obstacles to get over, let's say. In our goals, and if I may be frank here, I am worried out of my fucking head and desperately looking for any help we may be able to vouchsafe.
Have you been solicited by something?
no more than general group inquiries, I suppose.
Well, if you're saying that, then most certainly you've been solicited by something, because I swear
and Aaron's
trying to get into this group's panties, I mean.
Metaphorically speaking?
Sure.
If you
tell me a little bit about the entity, I could give you a little bit more information. But as far as general deals, Aaron, there's knowing what you have and knowing what they want.
All right. That makes sense.
Knowing what you have offered and knowing what you haven't offered.
I mean, there are...
It's like Hawk going and just giving his thanks to any old thing, or offering...
Ugh, I know, we need to talk to him about that.
Well, he's gotten quite a lot better over the time that we've spent together. In particular, yes, not throwing yourself into open-ended offers.
What, I mean, So set very specifically what are you willing to give. Arrive with some sort of list on what you are willing to go with.
Yes.
All right. That's good.
Never be afraid to haggle.
Okay. I can, this is just out a little. I can be someone who can haggle.
Can you be someone that can haggle?
I can't believe you would even ask.
Lish just kind of laughs. Like, you did not quite haggle when we were making our deal over your axe.
No, I did not. But I guess to your first point, I knew what I was willing to give up.
You know, I would perhaps be more amazed by that if all of you in this party weren't somehow so willing to give up so much of yourselves.
Yeah, that's that is what I'm worried about. I don't know. I don't want to just myself. I mean, I can't get anything done if I'm not there, or if I'm working at cross purposes, or what have you.
Staying as your own master. Now that is the key.
Odd heel nod.
What are you hoping to gain, Erin, that you do not already have?
Well, I would love to vouchsafe that you're all are, and his hands kind of clench up into fists here, or as many of you as possible make it through this in as few pieces as possible. And still breathing, if that's not too much to ask.
Lish just kind of smiles but sighs. Says, I don't know if there is an entity currently that can give you that sort of promise.
That we've encountered, that, or like because of the unraveling stuff, or in general?
I'm just saying that even gods like Char or Auril are running scared. They can give some benefit, it seems, but their willingness to full-heartedly fling themselves into our corner to save our skins.
I know, even though they are kind of who we're fighting for.
I would just be wary of big promises from these creatures.
I mean, what But they wouldn't make the type of promise they weren't able to keep, would they?
Depends on the creature.
Depends on the creature.
My folk may not lie, necessarily, but they may not give you the whole truth or their own ambitions that they're trying to accomplish with it. There could be side effects that you're not aware of. But outside of they, gods can lie all they want. So can any other manner of creature.
That, all right, makes they probably the safest option then. All right, well, I mean, I don't have any big rash plans currently. So,
Aaron,
no need to be worried.
Aaron, I will never not be worried for you. I would encourage you to stay as free as you possibly can for as long as you possibly can.
I would love to, and you have been doing my darndest. But Hags, there was this really, really like interesting, like fascinating flower that I was, well, almost offered, I suppose. But I do not think I wanted to give up anything that may have been asked of me to give up for it. But there are things that I would give up more for, I suppose.
Well, I suppose that as long as you keep your pockets full of interesting trinkets, you'll have plenty of things to barter with. And you won't have to rip into your soul to do so.
it's a good point. He's just gonna rummage around in his, I guess. I've picked up a selection of candles, not for deals or anything, but for shrines or temples we go to. Seems like a pretty universally appreciated thing.
Are you going to go around and solicit the gods?
Ugh. I guess I hope to not have to. To be honest, I think the path of religious devotion does not diverge much from the path of devotion to any other sort of creature. And you know, that can be something that works for you and is to your favor, and it can be something that isn't.
She just kind of looks at you fondly and a little worried.
Aaron's not being worrying at all. I don't know what you're talking about.
Liz just kind of like pats you on your back somewhat, like rustles your shoulder, just like, you know, before you go around trying to find power in other entities, talk to me about it and let you know if you're getting a raw deal.
Of course, of course. I trust your counsel on such mad things.
There's other ways to get what you want, usually. I hope you know.
Don't worry, I am, not shutting down any possible paths. But I suppose that will include this, if that's where I have to go. Well, I don't suppose you want Demir and Toby to wake up without you?
No, we've got some time. We can walk for a little bit longer. It's still so early. He's like, I'm amazed that we're all awake. He'll kind of like reach and kind of like brush your bangs a little bit and kind of see in the streetlight where you've kind of fixed your eye scar a little bit. And he'll kind of make a noise like, I was wondering if you were still on the fence about doing more of the scar removal.
I talked it over a bit with Mary and with Obi, and he kind of shrinks up into himself, and says, I've been thinking of scars as being a mark, signifier of my history, much like the tattoos under them. But I think wanting to keep them on has been a bit more of a punishment from me to myself. And I don't know. I think I'm ready to at least try forgiving me.
Lish just kind of smiles at that.
To that end, goodness, when we're not busy, if we are ever not busy for the rest of our lives, I do think I'd like to take you up on trying to track down how to get more.
More of the solve.
More of the solve, yeah.
Well, Aaron, depending on how things shake out, if I were to get my powers back before I was able to get you more of the salve, I would consider it a great honor to help you out with removing your scars.
Oh. Thank you, and the way I... I really hope to see that day.
Lish just kind of a little bit, though, like he's gonna tell a little joke of, I won't even make you pay very much for it.
And he'll he'll pause for a moment and then say, I saw you, you know, the real you, the full you.
Oh.
As part of the division we were given, believe, was, and he shrugs, and says, "It's beautiful, both in and of itself, and seeing you have it, I suppose."
She just kind of puffs a little breath, just
We all we've all got something we're fighting for. And then he's going to, you know, you can see him hesitating a little. And then he's gonna keep going. And I suppose that what vision is, well, not even vision really, that memory, I suppose. Glimpse into our first go around. Lish, everyone down, I believe some number of you died. I really have no idea who. I did not have time to check, but I mean, during that whole fight, I was just so useless. I was trapped right at the beginning of it, and I wasn't smart enough, I wasn't fast enough, I wasn't, I don't know, thinking enough to get out of it until right at the end, and then I got right over to English. I was right there. And I didn't do anything. I wholeheartedly failed. And all of you paid that price.
If that dream is true, and it was just a hidden memory of a time that didn't come to pass, but also did. A confusing thing. And if it is true, then I was at my full power as an archfey, also fighting with you. And also taken off guard by what happened there, and also fell. I don't think power necessarily was the problem. We were not prepared.
And that's what we get this go around.
The more allies we get and the more prepared we are, the more we know our opponent and what he can do, it will not matter how many bells and whistles and deals we make.
Aaron nods. Feels, I don't know, I mean, it feels like we know you know, so much more about what's happening. And we've got a number of people that, honestly, I wholeheartedly think we can count on. I don't know, but somehow, I mean, I feel like we're getting closer to being able to fight someone in the general sense, but sometimes it feels like we aren't really progressing towards being able to fight Eren in the specific, you know? I feel like we should be able to do more, and I don't know what more looks like.
I suppose we can only just work towards getting stronger, getting more information, readying ourselves.
Aaron will look back up, and he is gonna, you know, actually lish, and he'll shrug a little, and he'll say, "What can you do but what you can do?" And he'll smile a little bit.
Either we put in our best effort, or we don't. The world may or may not fall apart either way.
That's its own kind of comforting.
Believe me, Eren, my own frustration with our powerlessness is incredibly... It is my first priority.
He nods.
But we cannot... We can only do what we can.
Ain't that the truth?
If we can get my powers back, bring our allies together and up to date on what's going on, just make sure we don't sabotage ourselves.
That's an if.
Well, we might just have a fighting chance.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, you know, Strath believed we would be able to do something at least. And hey, I mean, if we all go down immediately, then we don't have to watch the consequences of our failure.
Precisely. See, we're taking ourselves out in the first wave if we fuck up. Well, Eren.
Is it weird that does make me feel better?
It's just kind of shrugs and smiles. Like, I don't know what else we can do. But if you me to put in a good word to Saloon for you. You know, I tried to put in a good word for Tobias with her, but Tobias didn't seem too interested. So if you'd like me to reach out to her on your behalf, she's a goddess that wouldn't do you dirty.
I think that's... Yeah, I suppose I'd appreciate that.
Well, whenever we get back to a place with a temple, I can make an introduction.
It's a good one.
I suppose,
you know, sometimes I just don't hit people right, you know? Especially at first.
Yeah.
And he's pretty much back into just, like, you know, normal bantery conversation at this point.
I think we'll start to kind of make our way back towards the inn.
Yeah.
All right. So, you guys make your way back to the Rowdy Raven. Everyone else eventually wanders down. Did you guys want breakfast, or are you just vibing?
Lish might get breakfast and bring it up to the room.
All right.
Lish kicking down the door with a cup of joe and a plate of breakfast burritos.
We'll call it 5 silver pieces.
Aaron will also take the opportunity to grab breakfast for, I suppose, just Falk.
All right. Are there any conversations that you'd like to have over breakfast?
I mean, when Lish brings Demure a breakfast burrito and coffee, she absolutely does that, like, slightly hungover sob of relief. And just takes her burrito and rolls over into the bed to slowly eat it.
Falk takes a much more in-depth sob since she's much further down the hungover rabbit hole. Burrito, ha ha ha.
I was going to ask if you're feeling all right, but I guess that answers my question.
I owe you a debt, Aaron.
Anytime, though, I do hope it happens less frequently. He'll start munching on his own little breakfast burrito.
Lish will make a little bit of his snowdrop tea that he has and kind of mumble while sipping it, like, I think I might put together a guide for making deals with other planar creatures.
Lish becomes an author. It's a bestseller.
No, really? I never thought that I'd become a published author, but perhaps mankind could use a little bit of a hand. I didn't realize exactly just how woefully unprepared humanity was.
Lish writes a how-to-make deals guide, becomes a best-selling author, and various fame becomes certified under his branch of this is someone that you can trust to make a deal. And so Faye compete to have a piece MLM. Of paper. Yeah, just like before making a deal, okay, here's my certificate of minimal fuckery.
Of course it's gonna have massive loopholes in it, okay? Like,
yeah.
You still gotta make Lish a living, right?
Lish is murmuring about, like, wanting to make a guide for humans to make deals. Demure just like, I thought you didn't want that sort of information out there. Doesn't that work against you?
Just the basic things. Like, you know, put together a list of things that you really don't care about losing. Know what you want to get out of the deal before going into the deal.
Lish approaching this with the mindset of, if these people get duped before they reach me, then I can't get anything.
I mean, yes, if they have lost already all of their bits and pieces before any higher level fae can get to them, then what's the
point? What's the point?
You know, you go into the fae wild and then all these lesser fae will nickel and dime all of the all of the good bits. Sorry, that's Kenzie laughing. This is just a very funny, stupid concept, and I love it. I don't think that it needs to be mass published. It's more of just an interest.
I mean, it's your job.
Oh, Erin was asking about it, is all.
Is Erin out to make a deal?
I think that he wants to be protected from such things. The more you know.
Indeed. Demir just goes back to her burrito. He doesn't have anything to say about that.
Lish just slurps teeth. Should we get ready to go look for more boats?
Yeah. Do we want to all go as a group again, or do we want to split up?
Fact finding first, and then see who's at port, or...
I mean, we figured, we learned last night that the captain is off to his own. I think we need to track him down.
Yes, that's what I mean, is we don't know quite where that boat and captain are.
Good point.
Falk, can you make a quick intelligence check for me?
Sure. We could just assume that she fails, but yeah, sure.
I mean, hey, you never know. Talked. You might roll a 17 or something.
Nope.
Oh.
I rolled a 5, and I think I have a 1. Nope.
Better modifier than
5.
I have.
No modifier.
Damn.
Valk, you feel like you saw Githyanki recently? Like, now that you're, like, drunk in bed, like, nursing your hangover, shoving a burrito in your mouth, like, all right, we're talking about a Githyanki. Didn't I just see one of those, like, yesterday? Can't remember exactly where, though.
Can I make an insight check to see if I remember a Githyanki?
No, because Falk was the one that saw him.
Assuming we're all together, like, well, if we don't know where to start, we can always start the ship. Maybe one of his crew members knows where he went.
I vaguely remember seeing a Githyanki.
You know where?
Was it before or after I started drinking?
I would hope
pretty sure it was before. Hard to say, though.
We could always retrace my steps.
I will say the major errand you went on alone was to the temple, so that seems somewhere along there seems the most likely.
Wasn't at the temple. Going through your head and what you all did yesterday, you talked to the dock master, who's a hobgoblin woman. You visited the Baker Street, some of you.
Repeatedly.
You went to the Lotto Grotto, where you found a skeleton and dumped said skeleton off of the dock into the water.
As he wished.
Then you went to the brothel.
Yeah, but everyone else was at the brothel.
Everyone was at the brothel.
But if I'm the only one who saw it...
I mean, you went in the brothel. The only one that went to dump the skeleton off of the dock.
He was that guy that looked at Valk all weird when she dumped out the box, wasn't he?
Bingo.
Amazing. We've already made a great first impression.
Well, time to make a great second impression.
All right.
Well, I'm not tempted to go back to the temple anytime soon, so I'd rather, you know, do the rest of my trips before that. So I guess Doc?
While you trace your steps, I can probably go to the ship itself.
All right, so we got Valk and Hawk going to the dock. I also heard people saying that they were going to ask around town about the King of Cut Purses.
If you guys could do that first, I need to go deal with something real quick.
Okay.
All right, who all is going to ask about the King of Cut Purses?
Aaron wants to be on that.
I think Lish wants to go to the boatyard.
Okay.
I can help with the cut purse situation. Okay. Lend my charisma.
And says, yeah, I don't know that I'm going to come off as someone who would be asking for nefarious reasons, I suppose.
Just look big and strong behind me. You'll be my bodyguard.
So, Erin and Demir are going to go ask around for the King of Cut Purses. Tobias, where are you off to?
Let's see. So, Valk, Hawk, and Lish are going to go to the docks. Can make it even, and... Tobias will go with Demir and Aaron to ask about the King of Cut Purses.
All right. And we'll say Septimus goes with the crew to look at the docks. So for those of you that are searching for information on the King of Cut Purses, I would love a persuasion check. I assume Demir is going to make this with advantage because Erin and Tobias are assisting.
Scared on privileges.
Unless anyone has a higher persuasion, but I don't think they do.
No.
Wow, my dice are fucky. that is an 18.
18.
Oh, wait. Yeah, no, that's an 18. I can't do anything else.
Okay. 18. So you start asking around about the King of Cut Purses. And you learn quite a bit. You know that he is a crime boss that kind of is in charge of the criminal enterprises within Saya. He probably could have a larger reach if he wanted to, but he seems content to be within that continent. He is very interested in the accumulation of wealth, of course, being a crime boss. Mm-hmm. But his area of interest specifically, the stuff that he specifically is interested in, even if his underlings are focused on gold, he really likes the collection, accumulation of rare and legendary artifacts. Like, you know, in the Magnus Archives, there was Thalesa, who liked to gather the objects, including like that magic camera and stuff. Kind of like those vibes. Like, he's willing to trade in these things, but he likes to keep specifically artifacts for himself. Because he is only within this one continent, he's able to keep a close eye on his underlings and the people that work for him. And you get the impression it's something like there's one or two people for most of the major cities of Thea, specifically in Nibeli, that are more or less considered his inner circle. And he can keep an eye on them, and they will keep an eye on whoever they recruit. And the idea is the recruits will gather wealth, give it to the people in the inner circle, and all in their checks and balances and all that fun stuff. And then they send off whatever the King of Cup Purses specifically wants to wherever his hideout is in Apotec.
I was going to say, did we find out where his hideout is? But that hideout in Apotec.
It's supposedly in Apotec somewhere.
Supposedly. Okay. Do we find out anything aside from the kind of general operation of his, like, crime empire? Is he like, do we find out like he is like a very like vengeful if you break from rank, or is it like he doesn't care if the underlings go, but if the like, but he will, like, you know, get involved if it's major, sort of thing? Like, he's involved in, like, he keeps tabs on anyone, but, like, how involved is he in the, like, day-to-day sort of little guy deal? Or does anyone know?
It's hard to say how likely he would be to get involved with, like, the underling. He's not afraid to make an example of people should he feel like they're holding out on him or they're crossing him. He has been known to murder people in his inner circle that try to steal from him. But the people within his inner circle would be more likely to dole out punishment should, again, they feel like they're being crossed or someone held out from them, or someone stole from them.
Cool. Party, is there anything else we wanted to learn or try to learn? Can we try and find out the names of the officers located in Royas? Is that something that would be known?
Not with an 18.
Fair enough. All right.
Oddly, people in this crime empire want to keep their names hush hush. Not everyone walks up to random men they meet in the woods and offer their full name and title. And then
how? Look.
The responding with, like, not even a period, but, like, a comma at the end of look. One thing we could probably ask about, like, because I'm curious as a player, if there's any significance behind the branding other than you're part of the gang now. Because we know about the brand. That's how we found out about Rosania and Echo and Egress's connections to the King of Cut Purses.
Yeah, like, how in do you have to be to get branded? Is that something all recruits are branded, or?
How do you get out?
Yeah. I'm seeing a big old shrug, so probably a...
Okay. Again, I didn't roll high enough, sorry.
Roll higher.
That's fine.
Sorry!
You've reached the increment limit for questions from number.
Valid.
I gave you a lot of information.
You gave me a lot of information on an 18. Thank you very much. I am not complaining.
18 is pretty good, to be fair. So a lot of information is fitting. But we have gotten enough.
Yeah. Okay. That's what I found.
Know the significance of the Ouroboros tattoo with the crown. Other than it is the symbol of the King of Cat Purses.
Okay, but that gives us a general idea, so we can
work with that. We adopted a pair of crime lords.
They are 12.
Oh my god, they're the officers in Royas!
I mean, they could.
They're the officers in Arroyas!
It would be very cool and very funny. But
I
highly
doubt it. What were you doing when you were 12? Think about it.
Dating the mafia bosses out. Adopting a mafia bosses in.
I was busy being undiagnosed autistic, so I'd have no clue what normal kids do at 12.
Not far off from the truth.
I was in 8th grade. Anyway.
Right. Lars do be back, so we can do doc time with that, if that's all resolved.
You said you were going to look for the moon kiss?
Yeah, I was going to go straight to the ship and ask.
Roll investigation check. Try and find it.
All right. Can't wait to fail horribly because I've got... It's very funny to me how, like...
Well, you can have advantage because people are assisting.
That's fair.
I am assuming people are assisting instead of just, go Hawk! Go find it! Go on, boy!
I mean, it would be very funny if Lish just, like, sat back and watched him suffer.
Well, Falk would be going towards where... She dumped the body, so you'd be at least in the general vicinity.
Yeah, I mean, Lish is helping look.
Yeah, okay. I assume so, but like, you never want to assume, right?
What's Hawk's perception? Are we percepting? Is that what's
we're investigating. I was about to say, it's very funny to me how I kitted out Zoda with her expertise to have very high investigation, and yet Hawk has zero.
I have a +1 to my investigation, so
I will give you advantage because that's better than zero.
What does Volk have?
Goose egg.
Well, yeah.
Nothing. Okay, well, excuse me.
The pain of having to move my casting step from intelligence to charisma, but it's worth it.
Okay, I will roll advantage. Let's see how this goes.
Oh, you can have guidance.
I got a 17.
Well, add a d4 to that.
Okay, 17. Oh, +4. So what is that, 21?
Yeah, it's 21.
21 plus.
Yo.
Alright. 21. So, first of all, I will note that the Eye of the Beholder is gone.
Good. Well, good.
Solves that problem.
Yeah.
They took your money and you did not show up at dawn, and so they left.
So they got free money.
Yeah.
Maybe you don't have to deal with cheated pirates at the docks, so that's good.
Not yet.
Not yet.
But anyway, you head towards the area where you dumped the body. And you do find the Moon Kiss. It seems much smaller than the warship before. It's there. You can see a red-skinned tiefling with kind of dark salt and pepper hair and elaborate sleeve tattoos, leaning on the side of the ship, smoking a pipe. Kind of keeps an eye on you guys as you approach.
Now, are you taking over negotiations here, Hawk?
I wouldn't mind having someone to back me up, but if you'd rather do something else, I won't keep you.
I'm happy to negotiate for us. How much money do we have to spend on this?
We did just spend a lot. I have a bit over 1,000 gold on me.
I have persuasion.
I don't remember.
I don't think that will fill our mouths or our coffers.
I assume that we asked Demir
how much party funds we have before we left.
We have 2,700 gold pieces in the party fund.
Okay. All right. We're approaching the Moon Kiss then?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Lish will kind of catch the eye of the tiefling that's leaning over the edge of it and just kind of raise a hand in greeting.
Tiefling kind of looks back at you and you can see his tail lash a little bit, but he raises his hand.
And Lish will call out and say, "Oh, ahoy!"
Hawk just sort of like snirks a little bit, probably.
He'll say, "Greetings. We were hoping to be able to speak with someone on your crew who's able to negotiate passage, perhaps."
Kind of looks you guys up and down. Says, "I think we might be able to arrange something. Hold on." He moves back, and you can see that this guy clearly is very strong because he's able to lift a plank so you guys can climb onto the ship like a little board. Oh.
Cool. He's lowering the gangplank for us.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. We'll look back at you two and start to walk on it.
Yeah. I was gonna have Hawk like playfully like half bow and gesture for Lish to climb aboard.
Lish's little half bow.
Yeah, he's right behind you.
Alk's just like, "Oh, my head," and follows.
The tiefling heads over towards the side where you can see the captain's quarters might be. Knocks on it, says, "Captain, we got a couple people here looking for passage." And you can hear a pause and then sort of a scraping and a rustling. And the door opens to reveal a Githyanki man. The same one, Valk, now that you see him, realize was the one that watched you dump the body off of the dock.
I remember when I saw you. Hi.
he looks like he's kind of bundled up in preparation for cold weather. He's got this sort of elongated face and sort of scaly pattern around his eyes and along his jawline that you'd expect for someone of the Gith race. His hair is short and dark and sort of twisted back into a knot at the base of his neck. And he's got a little bit of a scruff along his chin as well. And he kind of raises an eyebrow when he sees you, Valk. But as Lish is the one in the lead, he turns his attention towards him.
Greetings. Good morning.
Good morning. What can I do for you?
Well, myself and a few of my companions are seeking passage to Alperen, and we were advised that your crew and ship might be a optimum vessel to be taking such a voyage.
Well, we are headed in that direction anyway. How many are you?
I believe we are 7.
7, yeah. Because it's everyone in the call, minus Avery, because I mean, she's the DM, and plus a Septimus.
Yeah.
Well, I can't say that this is a fancy cruise ship or anything. This is a merchant ship. We move cargo around. If you are willing to seek rest within our crew quarters, I think wouldn't be too much trouble.
We are very used to roughing it.
We're quite used to sleeping on the road, and should you require it, I have minimal experience, but experience nonetheless with manning a ship myself. I have family over in Emerald and Harbor, you see.
I see. Well, I'd say that we could transport your group for let's call it 75 gold each.
That is very reasonable.
We set out in a day or two.
Wonderful. How long of a passage is it? How many days is it expected?
Just a couple days travel. Provided we don't run into any pirates or other creatures that might find their way out there in the north.
Awkward stare with pirate.
Also depends on if we need to stop to trade with the Selkies or anything.
Well, we're more than happy to assist in any defensive needs.
Very well. Most thing other than the pirate that you have to worry about is probably Wyvern, but they try to stick to the mountain. Just something to keep an eye out for.
Oh, we did slay that dragon.
Is it relatively calm waters then, or are there rough patches?
There are rough patches. Sometimes we have to go and break the ice. Sometimes we get unlucky and hit a storm, but we have a druid for assistance.
Smart.
DM, did we get this guy's name?
Nope.
Well, okay, so Lish will kind of hold a hand out to shake and say, well, I do believe that we may have an accord here, Mr.
You can call me Captain Zarich.
Captain Zarich?
Z-A-R apostrophe R-Y-T-H.
Okay, Zarich.
Zarich. Fun.
Rith.
Zarith.
Zarith.
Gotcha. Zarith.
Zarith.
And Lishel, does he shake his hand?
He does.
Yeah, Lishel shaking. Just be like,
he's got like a very firm grip.
Crushes my fingers. Just like, I am Lish, and these are the Wild Roses.
How soon are you looking to depart?
We could leave today. We could leave in a day or two. Ideally, the sooner the better.
Kind of ponder for a moment and looks out across his ship. How about this evening? Make sure most of my crew is sobered up.
Lish nods in a very understanding way, kind of out of the corner of his eye, glancing at Volk. All right, this evening then. If you need to send any notice, we are at the one local inn. I don't remember the name of it.
Does anyone know the name? Rowdy Raven.
Rowdy Raven. We are at the Rowdy Raven.
Very well. We depart at just after sunset.
And Lish will give him a little bit of money. Let me see. Let's
see. 75 per Sisyphetum 7.
So I'm going to give him, half? I'm going to give him 3 people's worth. So I give him 225 gold.
525 total. If you're doing 225, that leaves 300.
225.
If you're paying 225, that leaves us 300.
Yeah.
So I can pay that. That's fine.
I will also say that is a very reasonable price. He's giving you guys a discount. You get the impression because he's already headed that way and he doesn't care.
There is also party fund money, so this money can come out of the party fund.
That's fine. I'll give it to him out of my own pocket and then reimburse myself later.
While money transaction is happening, Val kind of reaches her hand out to the gentleman's like, hi, Val, in regards to yesterday, we were at the what's the shop with the
gambler?
The Lotto Grotto. And that was what we got. And I asked the gentleman how he wanted to be buried, and that was his request.
I have seen the far shadier things occur in this city.
Fair enough, but not exactly the best first impression.
I suppose not.
I wouldn't be surprised if some of his crew members have made worse before. Either way.
Yes, you say that out loud, Hawk.
No, probably not.
What is the shadiest thing you've ever seen in this city?
I've seen murders, I've seen fights. I try to mostly keep my head down and keep my crew safe.
Very wise.
Noble endeavor.
Smart indeed in a place like this.
The dock master and the town master are both paid very handsomely to turn a blind eye to many of the activities that go on here. I not paid for it, but I turn a blind eye as well.
Gotta make your livelihood somehow, I guess.
Indeed.
All right. Tonight, then.
Keep your purses close to you while on the island.
Well, the last pickpockets that we ran into, we ended up adopting, so doesn't bode well for the pickpockets.
Seems a little confused, but doesn't say anything about it. I'm going to run to the restroom real quick. I'll be right back if you guys want to check.
We can go and try and find the rest of the party then, I guess.
Probably, yeah. If we've got the deal secured and everything paid for. How much did we pay the Eye of the Beholder, actually? I don't remember.
More.
900 gold pieces.
Damn, we did get ripped.
We got so scammed.
No, we Valk checked with her stepdad. And while that was in the higher end of reasonable, but still reasonable, whereas we're getting the much lower end of reasonable.
That's fair, because like we were also asking them to advance their schedule, weren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So like,
whereas in this case, it's get, like, I mean, we're already going that way.
5,000 gold pieces for a rowboat scammed, but we got like
we got a little bit grifted.
We got a little scammed.
Yeah.
Hey. We got a fair portion of that back.
And I imagine we'll be getting a lot more.
No, we got a sword back. There's a difference. We still spent like 20,000 gold pieces on that stupid boat. So
if it's any consolation, we're probably going to get a bit more. I would be very surprised if this dragon doesn't have a hoard somewhere. Or if its parts like don't cost anything.
Yeah, I mean, we're just hoping that we find the dragon horde, but...
I mean, even if we don't, I'm sure that a moon dragon scale is going to sell like hotcakes to alchemists and wizards.
Well, we could
You go for it.
Maybe we could do capitalism and buy its teeth, as opposed to having to do a murder.
I mean, if the dragon's that sapient, then sure.
I'll give you
true.
Like you can try that theory out, Valk. We will give you all of the runway to try that out.
It would be interesting bartering with the dragon.
Yeah, Valk does her best not to, you know, kill sentient things unless if they attack first.
Yeah, but don't dragons like kind of inherently think that they are entitled to all the gold in the world? Like, you can't trade with someone that believes that they're entitled to what you're trying to trade for.
It does depend on the dragon, to be fair.
Chromatic dragons tend to have that selfish streak to them.
Mm-hmm.
Metallic dragons tend to be more friendly. If you're searching for a white dragon that breathes fire,
most likely chromatic. Weird, but still chromatic.
So we're going to find the rest of the group.
Yeah, we're going to find this group.
You guys are able to reconnect without too much trouble.
Well, the good news is that we have passage tonight. Relatively cheap. The bad news is that we probably got a little bit scammed before.
I mean, it's probably to be expected from a...
Pirates and all, yeah.
Yeah.
Eh, we could just say it's costing 1,400 for passage in total and call it good enough.
Well,
who knows, if our luck is bad, we might run into them on the water. We'll be able to get our money back.
Well, if we are here until the evening, oh, and Demir would have told everyone what she found out about the King of Cut Purses.
Which was...
Can I have a little summary so I can type it down?
Yeah, well, I mean,
I can also just copy paste what I wrote.
That's fair.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The notes. I have them open for a reason. Like,
she just tells them everything she learned. Like, she's not holding anything back. She's just telling them.
Thank you so much for being a stenographer, Kenzie.
for Kenny. If we're here for the day, there is a bathhouse. If anyone is interested, I would certainly like to feel clean for once before we depart.
Well, I would love a bathhouse.
Is there a bathhouse around here?
Mm-hmm. There's one right over there. No, look, no, left, to the left, your other left, Hawk.
Calling me out on webcam? I'm just taking notes.
Bath could be nice.
It could.
You could continue exploring with the necklace and have your first real bath.
I think I'd rather just make sure the metal's all polished.
Oh, come now, Hawk.
Last night, Hawk. You were using the necklace.
Yes.
Well?
Well, what?
What did you think?
Something I hadn't experienced before, per se. You might remember that brief body swapping episode we had. I'm sure some of us wished we didn't, but it was interesting getting more used to it over a longer period of time. I was mostly doing it to actually try some of my winnings from the Lotto Grotto.
Well, if you want to experience a bath, I'm sure you're welcome to join us.
Yes, you should take advantage of the opportunity.
I'll consider that once I've actually secured a pair of bath trousers.
You don't... The point is to get clean.
Here, you can just take mine. I won't be wearing them.
I will say, Hawk, one of the best parts of being alive, in my opinion, is getting to get all cleaned up.
Oh, I've experienced that. And I would prefer to consider you to experience it in my own way.
Fair enough.
You can see Valk doing her best not to make a joke. Just like,
listen, I may not have a pulse, but I am definitely alive.
No, not you. I thought Demir's favorite thing in life was to get dirty.
You get dirty holding it back, and then you get all cleaned up. It's part of the process. It's all part of the same experience.
Makes me want to try it even less.
Demir is going to look at Toby and Lish already said that he was interested in the bathhouse, right? Then she'll look at Toby and just be like, do you want to join us, or do you want... Do you have other business in town?
I don't see why not. It would be a nice change of pace.
You can join us this time. Last time you and Lish went off on your own in the bathhouse. This time we can all see if we can soak together.
Can't they all soak together at one point? Because I know
We have in place with the bath dragons. We all were in
the same place. The bath dragons. Shit, I almost forgot about the bath dragons. Yeah, okay, never mind. I take back what I said.
How could you forget about the bath dragons? Come on.
I wasn't there.
Treasure it, Marie, the bath dragon.
The bathhouse Drake was like the best boy. I love him so much. I don't know how I forgot about him.
He's good. He's covered in soap.
He's really slippery, okay?
Well, let's go investigate. And Hawk, you don't have to come in, but I think it would be fun.
Well, where do you think I'm going?
Yes. He'll scoop his elbow, loop arm elbows with Hawk and head going.
All right.
Bro's walking like.
So, called the North Pine Bathhouse. It's got sheer stone walls that only open high above where small window slits let in small rays of light. The foyer is bare, but for a table where one pays their fee and a couple of crates. It would be about 6 silver pieces each to partake. So if you guys want to mark that down.
Yes.
How much each?
6 silver pieces.
6 silver?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. Just
make... I assume I can get change for a gold piece.
Yeah.
Cool.
There we go.
All right. And once you guys have paid, you are given towels that are well washed and carry a scent of herbs. It's a nice change from the kind of salty, brisk air of the rest of the town. But you were then led to public bath area, which is tiled with a beautiful mosaic pattern of beautifully, scantily clad women giving attention to the bath patrons. Further in, you can also find a sauna with wooden benches and a fire pit warmed with rocks, with steam kind of obscuring the room. There aren't many people in here at this hour of the day. It's just warm and comfy, and it's nice. Good.
So are people wearing towels around their waists, or is it just
so.
A free bird, or?
It seems to be up to whoever, to how they want to do this.
Well, Vault whatever probably requests a second towel so she can do both waist and head wrap.
Aaron's letting it all hang out.
Tobias will
yeah,
have
I don't think...
towel wrapped around his waist, but his people will be able to get a full view of his scars that are layered up now. Valk hasn't seen him before, but Tobias has a sizable bite scar on his left shoulder, and then his back has a massive burn scar stretched over it, but underneath it she can still see some traces of like a scar from where it looked like flesh had been ripped, and there's a slight divot.
We'll say that the only couple people that are in this larger bath area, there is a dwarf woman with kind of curly dark brown hair and a nice little scruff on her chin. She's asleep. She's just kind of like asleep on the side of it. And then there's a a couple of sailor types, type gentlemen that have their own little corner where they're sitting, and they're just totally ignoring you guys.
Demir is not clothed, but she's definitely using the towel to like sit down on. Like,
woman just has her tits out, but you know.
Demir is just going to go about, like, I assume that there's a place to get cleaned off, like a shower and all that stuff. Yeah. She's just going to go that way.
Well, why would you shower when there's washers?
Well, you get yourself cleaned off first, and then you go to the masseuse. Like, it's only polite. Have you never been to a bathhouse before?
good point.
Did the nuns not have a bathhouse?
I would imagine not like this, even if they did.
Yeah, we'll go with that. Oh, yeah.
I'm imagining a bathhouse where you're wearing full habit the whole time.
Well, one, you don't need to imagine because Valk it has towel wrapped around head. And
oh
two,
my god, oh, you're.
Oh yeah, she probably has a bunch of like beginning to poke out feathers like all up her legs and like shit. Because yes. She's coming out of her molt.
Lish is gonna loop his like hand kind of around Toby's waist for a second and just give him a big old peck right on his shoulder where the bite is, and then give him a big old peck on his cheek before he goes over to wash off.
Oh yeah, Valk would have a remarkably few number of scars because she's always been able to use magical healing to accelerate, and so just little faint, wispy things.
Tobias will follow after Lish and wash up as well.
I don't know if the pixies love the bathhouse or don't love the bathhouse.
I could totally see one like floating in like a teacup in the baths, sipping honey or whatever.
They're going to the sauna.
The pixies are?
Yeah.
Good for them.
Can't wait for them to overheat within 1 minute.
I know, Gree is
their
like
body so small.
An actual snowflake, and he's just like, yep, this is what I want to do with my
He is going because the other two are dragging him along.
Kicking and screaming in tiny little pixie voices.
Demir might make an intervention on Gree's behalf because we don't want a melted pixie. sure. And scoop Gree up and just be like, you two can go on your own. I believe in the two of you. Would you be able to help me with my hair?
She immediately starts going up into your hair.
wait, hang on. So I remember like the pixies have like actual sort of like forms or things are supposed to be, like Gree's a fly or something, right? Or is that someone else?
Gree's a snowflake, Vettel is a flower, and Bright Mellow is a bug.
So we do have steamed vegetables in the sauna now.
Steamed blossoms.
Steamed greens.
You ever see those like those squash, like the stuffed squash flowers? It's like that.
Look that up.
Rip.
Just a little scrungly. That's fine.
I've never heard of stuffed flowers before. That's interesting.
I feel like Vettel is kind of a tropical orchid-looking thing, so maybe she'll do all right in the pot.
Probably.
But Gree does your hair, Demir, getting it all tidied up. And then kind of looks around, starts going towards the sleeping dwarf.
Demir will just, in Sylvan, be like, behave yourself.
Man's going to wake up with the most magnificent beard he's had in his life. She.
Most magnificent beard she's had in her life.
Yeah. I mean, truly.
Gree starts working her beard. Doesn't notice. But yeah, everyone. How fast do we need to wrap this up? I just realized it's 12:04. Do people have things this afternoon, or do you want to have a conversation in the bathhouse?
I need to go.
Okay.
Yay.
So conversation will be next time.
So we'll hold off till next time.
That's fair.
In the meantime,
could be a fun place to start next week.
Good. Yeah, good place to stop.
Good place to stop, good place to start next week.
Yeah.
Thanks for playing, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for DMing, as always.
It was so good to game again.
Yeah.
Yes. Miss Bird.
Good session. Good conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for DMing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we'll see you next time.
Bye.
See you next time.
Farewell.
Bye.